I would like to introduce you to our wonderful speakers from HelpAge India. We have with us Mr. Prakash Narayan Borgaonkar, who is the head of HelpAge India for Maharashtra and Goa. He's been serving HelpAge India for the past 32 years. His responsibilities include fundraising, implementing and monitoring various aged care programs, advocacy, networking with government and other stakeholders. Welcome, Mr. Prakash Borgaonkar. I would also like to introduce Rajiv Kulkarni, who's a manager for Pune HelpAge India. He's with HelpAge since the past 16 years, and he covers, incidentally, 16 districts of Maharashtra for fundraising activities, as well as to monitor different projects like mobile Medicare unit, support to old age homes, sensitization of school children towards respect for elders, special guidance to MBA students under internship programs.
Yeah, this is Prakash Borgaonkar. First of all, thank you very much for conducting such a nice webinar. And as you all are aware that HelpAge India is exclusively working for the cause and care of elderly people. And we are working more than four decades, more than 42 years across India and serving the elderly people. No doubt, our focus group is poor and destitute elderly, but we support all elderly irrespective of caste, religion or economic status. What we have seen that even though we are in the 21st century, we talk about the development, everything, but still we look at our elderly as an unwanted group. Just to give you a brief idea about this elderly demography so that you will come to know what is the scenario today. In India, we are having more than 110 million elderly people today. When I say elderly, that means those who are aging 60 and above. And out of that, 90% are not having pension, they are not getting pension. So that means they are not having a regular income. 40% senior citizens are living alone. They have children, they have relatives, but nobody is staying with them. And most important is 53% are female. So that means the female population is more than the male in this older generation. And what we were talking about in Indian culture as a joint family system, that is also breaking up a fast. And because of these elderly left to be isolated and neglected. And that is what the role of HelpAge India is very, very important. We are developing different programs and the projects so that elderly can live a dignified life. We are in healthcare, we are in a social protection, we are in a financial inclusion, we are in a livelihood also. Now, since I told you about this, our elderly population and the work, what we are doing, we are running a 160 mobile van, giving free treatment at the doorstep of the elderly. We conduct 35 to 40,000 free cataract operations every year. Then we have our helpline. That is 1-800-180-1253. This is our toll-free number and this works 24/7. So through this helpline, we are giving counseling and guidance to the elderly people, whether it is related to their health status or whether it is legal guidance or how to prepare a will. That also we are providing information to them. Even we are supporting the old age home. HelpAge India has its own old age home across India. We have only 4 old age homes which are managed by HelpAge, but more than 200 old age homes has been supported by HelpAge India. We conduct the different types of health checkup camps. In addition to this, we also conduct awareness session where we are talking about the productive and healthy aging. That is very important. And now when this COVID situation has suddenly arisen, and everybody was talking about this corona infection and everybody says that the elderly are most vulnerable. So everybody was talking about that elderly must take care for this. And that is what the role of HelpAge is very important. So in the beginning, what we have started, first we created awareness about this, how to take care in such situation. What are the do's and what are the don'ts? How to wash your hands, then putting up the mask, all these things. That also we have created awareness amongst the younger generation as well as the older generation. Through all the media, whether it's the social media, whether it's through the Zoom meeting, through the print media or electronic media, even contacting personally also, we created awareness about this. When the second stage has come up, the lockdown has started, what we have noticed that most of the senior citizens, they were started facing certain problems. Especially those who were staying alone. Because of the lockdown, they were not able to go down from their place. Even in most of the societies, even the family member, they didn't allow them to go down. So they were very much having this problem, how to get their vegetable, their medicine and the fruits, everything. So they used to call us, and when we also started calling, we able to understand this problem. And that is what the HelpAge role is very important. So our team members, they talked this senior citizen, they contacted, they found out what do they need. And based on that, they prepare their requirement list. And the very next day, we have delivered whatever the goods they wanted at their doorstep. Even in case of the old age home, we also noticed that most of the old age home, they were facing the ration problem. And there then we started the providing ration. In the beginning, we provided the cooked food to the senior citizen. Even though those who are in the old age home, those who are staying alone, those who are on the road, those who are staying in the slum area, and even the beggars, even we are supported to the migrant worker also in the beginning. More than 2 lakh cooked food packet we are distributed. It has been supported by the different organizations. Then we started distributing the dry ration kit. That's what we call it as survival kit. Now in this dry ration kit, we are giving rice, atta, oil, sugar, chili powder, turmeric powder, then phenyl, then a packet of the mask, so many such things. Then we also prepared a separate hygiene kit where we are giving the sanitizer, we are giving the mask, we are giving the phenyl and the soap. Even in the survival kit also, we are having the bath soap and washing soap also we have kept it. And such kit we are distributing to the different old age home, to the senior citizen who are staying alone, senior citizen who are living in the slum area, seniors who are living in the community on the roadside also. And we are helping them and we are providing these dry ration kit. So more than 60,000 such kits has been distributed. More than 5,000 such hygiene kits also we have given to them. But what we had noticed in this pandemic situation, you know, we all are talking about the social distancing.
Right.
Absolutely right. It is fact, but it's a physical distancing. It is not emotional distancing. It is not that you should disconnect with your own people. Because when we received the call from the senior citizen, we were surprised. I'm just giving you an example. Other day, you know, in my last interview with the radio, I told them that we are in a lockdown. So I told them in Hindi that band kamre mein zindagi guzar rahi hai. And it's a fact. Band kamre mein zindagi guzar rahi hai, lekin apne dil ke darwaze to khuliye janab. Yes, you have to. That's what we urge people, that just call your seniors, call your grandparents, call your parents, find out what do they need. And that is what HelpAge India has taken one initiative recently. We have virtually connected to many people.
Okay.
Yes. 28 April, It was 28 April was the 42nd birthday of LPG India.
Wow. Okay.
Yes, so we celebrated. So what we did, we created corporate, and the corporate young said, yes, we will virtually connect to the residents of old age home. So we connected 5 old age home, one from Goa, another second one from Palghar, third one from Gurdaspur, Punjab, fourth from Neyveli, that is Tamil Nadu, and fifth from Cuddalore. See the different places. So 5 old age home, they have been connected virtually along with the employees of the corporate and the HelpAge India staff. We had a 90-minute session with each of the old age home.
Wow, this is social networking in the middle of social distancing.
So we have given the seed capital to them, and they are earning their livelihood very happily. They are very productive, very energetic. Lakhs of rupees turnover they are doing, you know. Now during this pandemic, you will not believe, these our elder celebrity group, they themselves have collected the ration and provided this ration to the needy elderly in the community.
In the rural areas?
Yes, in the rural area.
Oh, that's wonderful.
Yes, and they clearly told us, you don't worry, we'll take care about all these 5 villages. Not only that, they started, you know, preparing the mask, cloth mask. And they themselves distributed in all these rural areas, in the villages. It's a fact. But when it comes...
Yes, sir. Good evening, sir.
Good evening. Yeah, I told we wanted to supply this dry ration even in Pune. And that is what I asked Rajiv. Rajiv, you can share your experience about the vendor.
Yes, sir. Hello. Good evening, everybody. And first of all, thank you very much to Anaga and Elite for joining us in this group. In Pune, since last 15 days, we are distributing the dry ration, and we have different experiences with this distribution chain and all so many things. Initially, first of all, I would like to say this lockdown started in 23rd of March. Initially, nobody was aware about this will go very long. So people got the ration or food for maximum 10 to 15 days. But after that, what? After that, we have started and we are giving them again the dry ration, but we need to identify the people who are not able to get the ration or anything. In fact, in my area also, wherever we are distributing the ration, some people, because of their self-respect, they are not coming forward to accept the ration and all. They are just seeing us, these people are giving, but how we can go in and stay in the line. So we identified such people and we cross-checked their family background and everything, and we came to know there are no any earning member in that family, and since last 2-3 days they don't have a single thing of ration or anything, a food. So we identified such people and we have given them also the ration in their home. I personally handed over the ration kit to them, and that granny, she was 78 years old. She was very much happy. And on the next day, she cooked some small dish for us also, for our team. And she offered us. So that was a very touchy experience at that time. But again, it was a very touchy experience, and some other experiences also were there. But nowadays in Pune, what I've seen, so many people, even they are having the ration with them, but they want the ration again, and they're not thinking about the people who are completely hungry and who don't have anything. They're not thinking about them also. So we need to advocate for that also. In one family, at least take one, and the other should go to another family who are needy. So we are advocating on that also. And in all these things, I'm getting support from government officials also, some policemen also supporting us, some local persons, also, local volunteers also supporting us. And we are doing all these things since last 15 days. But nowadays...
You've been collaborating with...
with some local people, yeah, some local, I have a very small team in Pune, but we are doing so many things. And secondly, the main thing in Pune nowadays, there are sealed areas in so many areas in Pune are sealed, and even my office area is also sealed. So we are struggling for that also. We are taking so many permissions. We are taking help of police and society people also.
Yes, that's another challenge, right? I mean, because if you're in a challenge. Zone and you need to take permissions and you need to
correct. That's everything we are doing. But
getting permission, that is also there. But I must mention here one thing, that we are getting good support even from the government and the police department.
Yes, sir.
That is very important because they do understand. Not only that, there are even in case of Mumbai and other places, I'm talking about across India also, certain cases have been referred and given, very genuine cases by these police and the government also.
Police and government officers. Yes, that's true, sir. That's true.
So because of that, what happened, we could able to reach out to them because they know very well. Which are the people who need this. But again, coming back to the point which Raju could not elaborate, that was the vendor. Because vendor and getting all the items from the vendor is really a difficult. Because when we talk about the kit, it includes 7-8 items together. And that is what getting that on time. Because the timing also again is very important. So we had a problem. And secondly, once we got a vendor also, then for a vendor to arranging transportation also was a problem. Because again, they had to take permission from the local government and the police. There are so many things. Anyway, we are providing a letter from our side so that they should aware that this, whatever the stuff they are carrying, it is for the NGO. For the